Hi students, in the first video we had discussed about introduction to macroprocessor. There we studied what is macro, what is macro prototype, what is macro invocation and what is macro expansion. So in this video I would like to discuss about the algorithm and data structure for macroprocessor. That means in this video we are going to study how the macroprocessor works. So just look at some key points. So it is easy to design a two-pass macroprocessor in which all macro definitions are processed during first pass and all macro invocation statements are expanded during the second pass. We already know what is two-pass algorithms. Two-pass algorithms means the input program will be read twice. So here what happens, in the first pass all macro definition will be processed, and in the second pass all macro invocations, during the macro invocations the macro will be expanded. We just look at the second point. However, such a two pass assembler would not allow the body of one macro instruction to contain definition of other macros, because all macros will have to be defined during the first pass before any macro invocation were expanded. So what do you mean by body of one macro instruction to contain definition of other macros? Is nothing but nested macros. So what's the meaning? To handle nested macros we need more than two passes, but here in the case of macro processor we need only one pass. So what we are going to study here is an one pass macro processor. So there are three main data structures involved in our one pass macroprocessor. Three main data structures means three tables: DefTab, NamTab and ArcTab. DefTab means macro definition table. NamTab means macro name table, which contain name of the macro. ArcTab is argument table. The table will contain macro arguments. So macro arguments and parameters we already discussed in the first video. So we just look at the first table, DefTab. DefTab is nothing but macro definition table. Macro definitions are stored in a definition table, DefTab, which contain macro prototype and the statements that make up the macro body with a few modifications. Command lines from macro definitions are not ended to DefTab. So before looking into this table, we'll look at an example. So here in the left hand side I have an input program and the right hand side I have an output program. So line number 5, we all know copy is the name of the program, start denotes starting point of program. Just look at line number 10, what's the opcode there? Macro. So this is a macro prototype. What's the name of the macro? RDebuff. How many parameters are there? Three parameters are there: indev, buff ADR and rec length, record length. Three parameters are there. So RDebuff is a macro with three parameters. So line number 32, this one, line number 30 to 90 contains the body of the macro RDebuff. 95 contains mint, that denotes end of the macro. So how, this is the main program. So how many macros are there? Here RDebuff macro ends here. Then another macro called WRBuff. So it ends at line number 155. So two macros are there and then followed by the main program. Just look at the main program. Here we have C loop RDebuff. RDebuff is an opcode, but nothing but it's the name of a macro. That means this line number 190 is a macro invocation statement. Line number 190 is a macro invocation statement. Why? So opcode is a macro name followed by three arguments. Similarly, we have line number 210, this is also a macro invocation statement. It actually invokes the second macro, WRBuff. Similarly, we have one more macro invocation statement at line number 220, that is also WRBuff. It also invokes this second macro. So this will be the input given to macro processor, and the right hand side program will be the output. So what happens? Copy start 0 will be copied as it is. So from line number 10 to line number 165 contain two macros. Macro definition will not be there in expanded program. What's the next statement in an output program? First STL RETL. It is copied as it is. Next line is a macro invocation statement. So actually we are calling RDBuff or invoking macro RDBuff. So that prototype will be included in the output program as a comment. So in assembly level program, comments are denoted starting with dot symbol. Dot C loop means this line number 190 is a macro prototype. So what's the next statement? LDA length. Sorry, this will be expanded. So it will go here. Clear X will be copied. Clear A will appear here. Clear S will appear here. Plus LDT 4096 will appear here. Here what is given? TD. TD means test device equal to X ampersand INDEV. Ampersand INDEV means it is a macro parameter. That macro parameter will be replaced by macro argument. So this INDEV will be replaced by F1. So here it is TDXF1. Similarly, in line number 60, we have macro parameter. So it will be replaced by RDINDV again. INDV is the first parameter. So it will be replaced by first argument RDXF1. Then another one. In line number 75, we have STCH ampersand buff ADR. Buffer ADR is the second parameter, so it will be replaced by buffer. STCH buffer comma X. Similarly, here we have STX REC LTH. REC LTH will be replaced by the third one, length. So STX length, it will be replaced by STX length. So how I got LDA length here? LDA length is actually line, it is the copy of line number 195. That means this macro invocation statement is already expanded. So line number 198 to line number 190M will be the expanded version of this macro invocation. Similarly, it will invoke, the macro will be invoked expanded based on, expanded based on line number 210 and 220. So just go through this example. So we'll again go back to our tables. So first table is definition table. So definition table will contain the macro definition. It actually contains definition of RDBuff. So RDBuff, the first line, INDEV, buff ADR, REC, LTH, that is there in the definition table. And clear X, clear A, clear S, plus LDT 4096. Then this line TD equal to X question mark 1. That is given here TDX ampersand INDEV. How I got this value 1? Here actually in the input program it is given as X ampersand INDEV. Here INDEV is the first parameter, so it will be given the position notation 1. Similarly in the program it is RDX ampersand buff ADR, here also it is ampersand INDEV. So since INDEV is the first parameter, it is replaced by positional notation 1. Similarly, here we have STCH buffer ADR comma X in the program. So here buff ADR is second parameter, so it will be replaced by 2, positional notation of buff ADR. Just compare with the program and this table. So here I have STX, there it is STX RECLTH. So RECLTH is the third parameter, so it is replaced by positional value 3. So it is given there the statements that make up the macro body with a few modification. What's the modification there? The parameter names will be replaced by its positional notation. INDV is first parameter, so it is replaced by 1. Buffer DR is the second parameter, so it is replaced by 2. RACLTH is the third parameter, so it is replaced by 3. The next table is name type. So in name type, we will enter macro name. What's the macro name here? RDBuff. And it contains two pointers. First one points to starting the of macro body, and the last one indicates the ending of macro body. So macro names are entered to name type, which serve as index to def type. For each macro instruction defined, name type contains pointer to beginning and end of definition in def type. So name type will contain name of the macro and pointers to denote starting and ending point of that particular macro. So next is arc tab. So arc tab, this table is filled during macro expansion. This table is filled during expansion. F1 buffer length. From where we got these three values, F1 buffer length? So here we have a invocation statement. I already said arc tab will be filled during macro invocation. So during this invocation, arc tab will be filled with argument values F1, buffer and length. So it is used during expansion of macro invocation. When macro invocation statement is recognized, the argument table stored in the argument are stored in arc tab according to their positions in the org list. There in the first argument is F1. So F1 is filled, second is buffer, third is length. So arc tab is always filled during expansion of macro invocation. So three tables are there, def tab, name tab and arc tab. The key points to remember is when the definition is entered to def tab, the parameters are replaced by positional notation. So this is all about data structures used in OnePass macro processor. The algorithm will be discussed in next video. Thank you.